everyone. So, I'm Kung, and I'm wanting to show off an update with my Max Block Blade Vortex character. And so I have a crematorium rolled up that I had started and actually like just jumped in, but when I realized I should record a video of this. So, I'm going to point out the map mods first. So there's 40% reduced regen, monster life, monster crit chance and multi, LMP, 3 additional projectiles, and those were the mods on the map. So I'm going to go ahead and just get working on punching through this map to help show off the build. I recently hit level 19 gems, which is definitely a nice boost. And yeah, I'm just working on pushing towards level 20 gems. I'll end up flipping some of them since all the gems that I'm using in my setup aren't quality. Yeah, just wanted to run this to give an overview or an update on the build. So you'll be able to find a link to the build guide itself in the description below this video. Sewer, nice return out of the crematorium. Wow. Alright. Let's see here, what else is on this level. Looks like it's it for this level, so we go down to the next one. So typically porcupines are fairly scary, but you can see, not even a problem for this build. Block's just really strong. We got a blue pack. Oh, village ruin, plus one. Definitely with the patch this evening, the performance improvements with really large packs with Blade Vortex, and especially the Piranus boxes have been a whole lot smoother. You don't like lag out completely and lose all your frames. Arsenal to plus one. So I mean, you can see that there's still definitely a loss in your frames, but it doesn't just absolutely end your all the frames and stuff that you have. Alright, what's on this bad boy? Revives. I don't think so. And I don't have a scour with me, so let's see, I think there's another little pack over here, and I'm gonna have to jump out and dump some of this off and grab a scour because I don't want to revive all those monsters. Alright. Let's just dump this stuff right quick. And we needed a scour for that box. Wait, scour. Yeah, I need to start remembering to run with some of these currency items more frequently. Okay. Because revives monsters is no good, so we're just ignited. Not a big deal. And nothing all that great. Pick up a few of these rares. And to the next level. So, I mean, you can see at the skill itself, I feel like it does pretty solid damage. But, I mean, again, level 19 gems, so we're not all the way maxed out yet. So Storm Herald, typically fairly scary. But you can see that handled it just fine. Order of the Frozen Sky. Frames. Maybe not as improved as I was hoping. Praenus box down. Where the Frozen Sky is starting to hurt. Definitely not the most efficient map I've ever run, but that's okay. Some Heralds of the Obelisks. Ooh, boys, okay, but typically those are much scarier, but 75 spell block really helps to make your character feel really tanky in tons of other wise, really rippy, really scary situations. Yeah, that versatile combatant is just an incredibly powerful ascendancy. An ascendancy passive to pick up. Right, that's the way down. What I'm really interested to see is how well this does against Crematorium Megara. Because typically on most builds I've played, you have to really kite her, and she is just one tough boss. We got a ghost next door. A few more rooms on this floor, and then it's boss time. First, okay. I want to make sure that I'm going to be overcapped enough with my fire res to be able to deal with flame ability. It currently appears so way. So we have 13 monsters remaining, which means it looks like it's just the boss room, and we're going to give Megara a go. So I don't know if I'm going to be able to do her or not, but it's worth a try. Holy moly, man, she still hits really hard when you do get hit. Okay, it's bad with the multiple firestorms stacked up on you. I don't know if I can do this. Or I at least need a ruby flask. Spell block really doing some work here. Max spell block really doing work. I feel like with a ruby flask you might actually just be able to face tank it though. Okay, some of those hit really hard. This is like such bad form for doing this boss too. Typically you want to keep moving like clockwise around the room. Alright, Megara down. 75 spell block and nearly 7k life is frickin' strong. Wow. Yeah. Just no overcapped fire res, no ruby flask, just 75 spell block. Okay. Yeah. Really strong. Definitely a really strong character. So if you actually play that fight well, you could probably make it a whole lot less scary and kill her much quicker. Anyway, thanks for watching.